Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. My guest, as usual, WWE COO Triple H.
How you doing, Michael?
Doing great. What a eventful week in WWE.
Seems like they always are, doesn't it?
But we've learned that we have a double main event for the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view event on the WWE Network a week from Sunday. First and foremost, inside Hell in a Cell, Randy Orton versus John Cena, the renewal of a great rivalry.
Yeah, probably one of the longest lasting, most storied rivalries of John Cena's career, and possibly Randy Orton's as well. These guys, when you've been in the ring that many times with a guy, you know everything about him. You know what he's gonna do probably before he does, which makes for a very interesting match. Inside Hell in the Cell, I can't wait to see that one.
Also inside Hell in a Cell, for the very first time inside that structure, Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose. Another one of those guys that have been in the battle inside the cell before.
Now, you know, and that's the interesting thing is Cena, Orton, they've been inside that cell before. They know what it's like. They know each other so well. Now, Ambrose and Rollins, they know each other very well. But they've never been inside that cage before. You know, it's like when you back an animal into a corner, you don't know how they're going to react, right? Well, when you get inside that cell, something happens to you. It changes you. It changes who you are as a competitor. And you either rise to the occasion or you crumble under the weight of that cell. It'll be interesting to see what happens to Dean Ambrose with that kind of pressure, on that kind of stage, and with that platform. Inside that cell, is he crazy? Or does he want the world to think he's crazy?
It's interesting that you say what's going to happen to Dean Ambrose. What might happen to Seth Rollins inside the cell?
You know, I spent a lot of time around the Shield before they were decimated. Seth Rollins created them. Seth Rollins destroyed them. I've been around all three of them a lot. Seth doesn't get rattled. Seth doesn't panic. Seth doesn't feel the weight or the pressure. He's methodical. He's a technician. He's the architect. I'm not worried about Seth Rollins inside that cell, other than will Seth Rollins stop before it's too late? I think Seth Rollins right now wants to make an example of Dean Ambrose. I think he wants to prove to the whole world what he's been saying, and that he is the future of the WWE. And I think he's going to do that at the expense of Dean Ambrose. Cinder blocks might have been just the beginning.
I understand that both Rollins and Ambrose will get a first-hand look at the steel structure this coming Monday night.
They will. Monday Night Raw, The Cell will be there. Maybe you can get an exclusive interview with The Cell, Michael. The Cell will be there. They will have their first opportunity to see it up close. Trust me, if you've never been in an arena, if you've never seen that cell, when you see it, when you walk in it, when that door closes behind you, or when it's lowered around you, it changes your world.
Next week in this forum, I would really want to pick your brain on what it's like to be inside Hell in a Cell. Only one other person in history has been in more Hell in a Cell matches than you, and that's the legendary Undertaker.
Yeah, I think between the two of us, we've been in just about every single one.
You have the best winning percentage, though.
Of course I do.
Switching gears now to another major story. Big announcement yesterday on WWE.com. The rubber match, so to speak, between Big Show and Rusev will happen at the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view.
Yeah, I can't tell you how excited I am for this. You know, you can look at both these competitors. Big Show, obviously a giant, been there forever, one of the most destructive. It's humbling to be in the ring with him. 7 foot, 500 pounds. He just manhandles you. His hand is the size of your entire chest. When he hits you, it's to be manhandled by somebody like that, it's a humbling experience. But yet, it's funny, this past week I felt something while I was watching Rusev in that match. I felt sorry for Big Show. Put politics aside. Put Rusev's country aside. Put his politics aside. Put the things he says aside. The bell rang And there was a certain point in time where I started to feel bad for Big Show. I started to feel sorry for him. If that's the Rusev we see at Hell in the Cell, and Big Show does not step up to being the giant that he can be, this is going to be a very interesting feather in the cap of Russia.